Hello everyone, my name is Harvey and today I will demonstrate how to set up a remote dial-in VPN using DrayTek SmartVPN client with OpenVPN encryption and TOTP multi-factor authentication, and also using DrayTek VPN Matcher because the server is hidden by NAT. Here is our 2927. We make sure that we have the latest firmware and that the WAN is up and running. We have set an LTE WAN using a USB dongle. Hence, we do not have a public IP for our VPN server. Therefore, we will need to use DrayTek VPN Matcher for that 2927. These are the steps that we will follow to set up the VPN Matcher. That is, open the VPN Matcher website, create a free account, register the router using its MAC address, and then do the same for the Windows PC on which the SmartVPN client will be launched. We now have our VPN Matcher website and we have entered an existing username and password. We have already registered two devices, but I will go through them step by step. So I start to edit the 2927, check the device description, and then type the MAC address, which you can get from the dashboard. We type the MAC address in there, but pay attention to the format used. Then we choose the device model, choose 2927, and set it as a VPN server. And finally, we get the LAN subnet from dashboard again, and the subnet mask, which is /24. We click save and then move on to PC1. Then we do the same as before. We label it as PC1 and then we need to get the MAC address. Usually an ipconfig/all will give you the correct info as shown here. Selecting the main Ethernet adapter, you can see that the MAC address finishes by DFD6. We transfer this info to the VPN Matcher. Again, we select the device model to be PC and the LAN subnet and network mask can be obtained by the same IP config display. And then we click save to record it. This was already done before and you can see the green dot showing that the PC has synced with the VPN Matcher. I will delete it and recreate it again in a few seconds. Let me just copy the MAC address and then I will delete the PC1 profile. Here it's done and I will recreate it quickly by clicking on Add Device. We type in the device description, then paste the MAC address, select the device model as PC and then type in the LAN subnet and mask. Et voilà. Note that the LED is no longer green. We will need to go to the SmartVPN client later to resync it. We now move to the 2927. We go to the VPN Matcher setup page and then type the VPN Matcher server address and then the router list key, which can be found on the VPN Matcher website. Here is the router list key. We copy and paste it on the VPN profile. Then click OK to save. And then click on Detect and Server. After a few seconds, you will see an IP address. Then you click on Get List. Two profiles will appear. And then you click on the Create Profile tab. Then we select a number. Let's say index 1. Give the VPN tunnel a username and password. So we now have our VPN tunnel created. Let's confirm it. You can now see that there is a new VPN profile created with the OpenVPN selected and a username and password set up. We now make sure that the OpenVPN service is activated. Again, it is strongly recommended to disable the services not used. Now we will configure the OpenVPN server. We already have certificates created and I will delete them all and recreate them again. So we click on delete all certificates and click on generate. After a few minutes, all four certificates will be created again. We can see the root certificate, the server client certificate, the trust certificate. We will now change the SSL server certificate from default to the one that has just been created. We click on the local services list and change it to the OpenVPN server certificate. Now we will set up the client config and export it. Type in a file name, example test open, select VPN Matcher as the remote server, and then click on export. Here we get the file downloaded, ready to be transferred to the SmartVPN client. Now the next step is to set up the SmartVPN client on the remote PC. These are the steps that we will need to follow. Download the OpenVPN community patch for SmartVPN and install it and restart the PC. Then check that the OpenVPN option is shown on the SmartVPN client. We'll go to this application note on DrayTek website and get the link for the OpenVPN patch. Be careful, it is not the one for Windows, but this one for Windows with SmartVPN client. Please make sure that the latest version is working, or else choose a previous version. At the time of recording, the latest version 2.6.5 was not working, so we chose the 2.5.9 version. Once downloaded, installed on the Windows PC, which will need to be rebooted, we will then see the OpenVPN option in the SmartVPN client. So we will now import the OPVN config file onto the SmartVPN client. We click on the import and then find the path of the OPVN file. We can immediately see that most of the fields are populated. We only need to type the username and password. We also go to the advanced option, type in the VPN Matcher server details and the authentication key, as explained before. And click on the get list. And then click on the stun detection and then click on OK when it has been synced. You can now see the green dot appearing again. Finally, we will set up the TOTP. The steps that we will follow are as displayed. Basically, it consists of generating a secret code on the 2927 and using it to synchronize the authenticator app on the smartphone. And each time you need a password, the authenticator app will provide you one, which is also synced with the 2927. And I will go through these steps one by one with you. But first, always make sure that the system time is up to date, as it is very important for TOTP to function. This is done. Now let's go back to the remote dial-in user profile. Now we enable TOTP and click on generate the secret code. Copy and go to the Google Authenticator. Click on the plus sign to create a new profile and click on enter a setup key and paste the secret code in that key field. Click on add and then a 6-digit code will be displayed. Copy this code back to the remote dial-in user profile and paste the validation code. Then click verify. Wait until you get verify successful message. Then click OK to finish. Now that our router is set up, we move over to the SmartVPN, slide the connect button, and the username appears, but now the password is empty, and we need a secret code, which we will get from the Google Authenticator. We check it on the app and we get 732744, and then type it in the password field. In the meantime, we have started a continuous ping on the router's LAN IP address, And a few seconds later, we get ping replies indicating that the VPN tunnel is up and running. We confirm that on the VPN connection management of the router, and we can see that the OpenVPN tunnel is displayed in green. This concludes our demo today on how to set up a dial-up VPN tunnel to a VPN server which is hidden behind a NAT by using DrayTek VPN Matcher. And we used OpenVPN encryption and TOTP as two-factor authentication. Thank you for your kind attention.